Hi everyone, I hope that you're all doing great. It feels so good to be back home and to be filming again because for the last few months I haven't been uploading as regularly as I used to because with all the wedding stuff, work, just working around the house, my schedule was packed and I couldn't find time to film. So I took a few weeks off this summer. I really focused on myself, getting back some sleep, reading a lot of books and brainstorming ideas for new content for the blog and the videos. So I thought it would be fun to incorporate more lifestyles a bit into this channel. So today I'm back with a book haul. Before we get started, as I told you, I haven't been filming in weeks. So excuse my English, it's all over the place because I haven't been practicing for a few good weeks now. So excuse me if I repeat the same words, which I always do, and if I have this really weird accent because I just speak French in real life, so that's gonna be interesting. So back to the book haul, I picked up, I think, 12 paperback books because Amazon had a great deal a few weeks back. You had 3 paperback books for £10, I think, so I picked up 12. And then I picked up some books on my Kindle to read on the plane to go to Las Vegas on our honeymoon in a few days. The first book that I picked up is The Versions of Us. Now, I've seen this book everywhere, in every bookshop, all over the internet, and that sounds very interesting because it's the story of a couple and how they met. And basically the whole idea is that one single moment in your life can change your whole future. And I totally agree with this idea, this whole butterfly effect. I really like it, really interests me. So this should be a fun read. Then I picked up The Unexpected Everything. Now, I believe this is the story of a girl who likes to be in control. Just like myself, she likes to plan everything, have a schedule, she knows what to expect, when to expect it. And then everything falls about and she has this whole summer to herself and nothing goes according to plan, so she has to learn to let go. And I thought this would be interesting because I'm a little bit like that myself, so that should be fun because I should be able to see myself in that character. Next book that I picked up is Everything Everything. This came up as a recommendation on Goodreads, which is kind of a social media all about books. I've been spending a lot of time over there this summer just updating my reading list, like catching some new recommendations. So I saw this one multiple times. It had great review. From what I understood, it's the story of a girl who never leaves her house and someone new comes in the neighborhood and he's really focused on getting to know her. So that should be fun. It seems to be pretty small and easy to read. So I look forward to this one. Next one is another book that I've seen everywhere. This is Notes from a Small Island. And I think this is all about Great Britain and funny things and the people over there. And I personally love Great Britain. I lived in England for a year when I went to boarding school. I was actually over there in early July. This book was everywhere, in every single bookshop that I went to. It has that one, so I decided to pick it up and I don't really know what to expect, but apparently it's very funny. Then I picked up this book, which has just the most beautiful cover. I mean, when my package arrived and I saw it, it was like, this is so beautiful, I'm a sucker for beautiful covers. So this is Beautiful Broken Things. And I think this is about a friendship between two girls and then a third one comes in and everything is kind of disrupted and everyone's trying to fit in and to find her place. So that should be interesting, but the cover is just so beautiful, I'm gonna display that on my bookshelves. Then I picked up this one, which I look forward to. This is Faceless and it's basically the story of a girl who got into an accident and she lost part of her face. So she has to get transplants and she basically has to learn how to get her life back because when she looks at the mirror, she doesn't see herself anymore and everything around her has changed so much, like the look of the people and her daily life. So this is something that really interested me. So I don't know, I don't really know what to expect, but this seems like a very vibrant story. Then I picked up The Woman Who Went to Bed for a Year. And really, I got sucked in by the title because, let's be honest, we all dream of doing that. So this is basically the story of a mother of two and then her kids go away to college, I think, or they basically leave home and she decides to climb into her bed and to stay there for as long as she can. So basically her husband is furious and disappointed and everyone around her is very curious, so that should be fun and pretty entertaining. Then I picked up I Am Malala, and this is basically the story of a girl who stood up for education and was shot by the Taliban. I'm sure you all know her because she actually won the Nobel Peace Prize a few months back. I'm not really sure when she won it, but I totally remember her talking on TV. And this is not the kind of book that I usually picked up, but I finished reading Yeonmi Park's book In Order to Live, where she basically tells her childhood in North Korea, how she escaped the country, and I thought it was very interesting. It was very emotional. It was pretty tough sometimes because you realize that this is real life. So because I love that book so much, I decided to pick up this one because I'm really interested in hearing her story. The next book that I picked up is The Art of Being Normal, and I think this is about the story of two boys. One stood up for the other and they became friends. I know that one of them wants to become a girl, so that should be very interesting, and I think it's very actual. Everyone's talking about transgender and you can never know too much about the subject, so I decided to pick it up. Then I picked up a very serious book, at least I think it is serious. This is Still Alice and it has been turned into a movie. This is basically the story of a woman who got Alzheimer's disease, and I guess it tells her story with the disease. And this is something that is very close to my heart because I actually lost my grandfather to Alzheimer's. So I'm really interested in reading this one. I guess it's going to be very emotional as well, but I look forward to reading it. On a lighter note, I picked up Bridget Jones' Mad About the Boy. I just love Bridget Jones. I read the books when I was a teenager. I saw all the movies. I can actually watch the movie and do the dialogues as the film goes. So I'm really looking forward to that one. It has been like, what, 10 years since the last one was released. And in this one, Bridget has a baby boy. So it's her, all her story with motherhood. And I'm really interested in that. I've heard mixed reviews about this one, so I'm even more curious to start it. And then the last paperback book that I picked up is by Sophie Kinsella. This is Finding Audrey. You might know Sophie Kinsella because she's the writer of the Shopaholics series, which is one of my favorites. I've read all the books multiple times. I just love it. I've read some other books by her, but this one I've never picked up, so I thought it was time to give it a go. Then I picked up some books on my Kindle app because I love using my Kindle app on my iPad whenever we travel because it's easy to read on the plane. If it's dark around you, you can still read by the pool, it's perfect. You have multiple books all on your iPad, you don't have to carry them around, so I just love that. So I have 5 books. I have 5 new books. I have When Breath Becomes Hair. This is the story of a man who gets diagnosed with cancer, and I'm not sure whether he's a doctor or a student in the medical field, but he's definitely working in the medical field. Then I have Playground, which is a story of a girl's childhood, and she basically grew up in the Playboy mansion. She was there all the time, all around that area, so it's gonna be really interesting. Then I have Room, which is the story of a little boy and her mother. And I think her mother is captive in a room. She has been kidnapped and she has been held hostage for multiple years, and she has a baby boy. And then I picked up Something Real, which I absolutely don't remember what it is about, but I know for sure that it came as a recommendation on Goodreads. And then I have Wonder, which is one of the best-selling books right now, I think. I guess this is a story of a boy who has some sort of weird physical appearances, and it's all about his story. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure that's that. So I have a couple of other books that I have on my Kindle just lying around, some samples and stuff like that. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. It was a bit different, but hopefully if you're a book nerd like me, you enjoyed it. If you have any books recommendation, make sure to pop them in the comments down below, because I try my best to read and answer all your comments, and that makes me super, super happy. And if you want to follow me on Goodreads, my profile is goodreads.com/Axel. I'm going to put the link down in the description box as well. So thank you so much for watching, and I will see you really soon. Bye everyone!